tonight's midnight special brought to you by Chevrolet. Chevrolet, building a better way to see the USA. Ladies and gentlemen, your host and song painter, Matt Davis.
Girl, you're getting that look in your eyes, and it's starting to worry me. But I ain't ready for no family ties. Nobody's gonna hurry me. Just keep it friendly, girl, 'cause I don't want to leave. Don't start clinging to me, girl, 'cause I can't breathe. Baby, baby, don't get hooked on me. Baby, baby, don't get hooked on me. 'Cause I'll just use you, then I'll set you free. Baby, baby, don't get hooked on me. Girl, you're a hot-blooded woman child, and it's warm where you touch it. I can tell by your trembling smile, you're seeing way too much in me. Girl, don't let your life get tangled up with mine, 'cause I'll just leave you, I can't take no clinging vine. Baby, baby, don't get hooked on me. Baby, baby, don't get hooked on me. 'Cause I'll just use you, then I'll set you free. Baby, baby, don't get hooked on me. Baby, baby, don't get hooked on me. Baby, baby, don't get hooked on me. 'Cause I'll just use you, then I'll set you free. Baby, baby, don't get hooked on me. Oh, baby, baby, don't get hooked on me.
Okay. Okay. Allison. Dude, it's too much. I'm gonna get right down here amongst you. It's a lot more fun if you get right down amongst one another, as a Wolfman might say. I'll do a little thing here. It goes like. As the snow flies on a cold and gray Chicago morning, a poor little baby child is born in the ghetto. And his mama cries, 'cause if there's one thing that she don't need, it's another little hungry mouth to feed in the ghetto. You know, I've done that song too many times, man. That's songwriter stuff. And every songwriter seems like sits down and does a medley of his hit. And I'm about the same as anybody else. I ain't no better than him. I'd rather do a medley, though, for a group of my peers as a medley of non-hits. 99 and 99.100% of you songwriters will not dare sing you the first song they ever wrote in their life. You fixing to find out why. I'm gonna sock it to you. I wrote this song, I was 16 years old. I wrote it, of course, for Elvis Presley. It was 1950. I'm afraid to tell you what 1950 it was, but it was way back here. I figured Elvis was bound and determined to do this. Here we go. You ready? 1, 2, 3, come look at me. I got a girl, she's something to see. Feet is big and her legs is hairy, but I'll stick around with my Mary, my Mary. Woo, my Mary. Wait a minute. It didn't go over that good back in. Fantastic. Needless to say, the fool never did record it. Later on in life, though, I found out what life was all about in college. I was going to college down in Atlanta, Georgia, at, I can't say the name of the school because it involves a commercial. Anyway, I found out what college life in the South was really all about back then. I wrote this song here. It says, I just talked to the weatherman. It's gonna rain on me today. I dropped my bubble gum in the sand and had to throw it away. I got out of bed, scratched my watch and wound my head. I'm so mixed up I can't think. I'm gonna put me a bar in the back of my car and drive myself to drink. Drive myself to drink. Drink. I never finished that. You know what I mean? Never finished that song. Later on, I found out really and truly what life was all about, and I still believe in this to this day. I wrote this duel here. Yeah. I like big dumb dogs, fireplaces and crackling logs. I like katydids, freckled faces and laughing kids. And if you like that too, maybe I like coconuts, cotton candy, and baby's butts. I never finished that song either. Once you get past baby's butts, there's not a lot left to love. Hey, thank you. Where were you when I needed you? Anyway, welcome to the Midnight Special. We've got a fantastic show for you tonight. And joining us are going to be the Doobie Brothers, Waylon Jennings, Billy Paul, Billy Preston, Joan Rivers. Joan Rivers, and backed by popular demand, the dueling banjo scene from the movie Deliverance. We'll be back. Beautiful. We'll be back with Billy Preston right after this commercial. We've got a guy on the show tonight that has been around a lot longer than he'd care to admit. He's only about 21, 22 years old, but he's been in the business a long time. Maybe 26? Okay. He used to play with, believe it or not, he was the lead organist with Ray Charles. He played on everything that Ray played on. He's been with the Beatles. He has probably gained more recognition than I'll ever hope to. He's a fantastic entertainer. Would you please welcome the fantastic Billy Preston.
Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Take these broken wings and learn to fly. All your life, you are only waiting for this moment to arise. Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Yeah, yeah, take these sunken eyes and learn to see. All your life, you are only waiting this moment to be free.
I know you're all familiar with this next group. Later on, we're going to hear their big hit, Listen to the Music. But right now, here they are with their new record, Jesus is Just All Right. The Doobie Brothers.
Oh, one of the big hits of 1972, and now in 1973 it's a million seller, and has just been nominated for a Grammy Award. It was recorded by a wonderful man who originally from Philadelphia now lives in Los Angeles. His name is Billy Paul. Will you please welcome him?
Thank you.
The same cafe, and we're gonna hold it like we used to. We're gonna talk it over, talk it over, talk it over, talk it over. We know, they know, and you know and I know that it was wrong. But I'm pretty strong. We're gonna let them know now. We got a thing going on, a thing going on. Mrs. Jones, 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 Mrs.
After you've heard, a lot of people have heard me talk about poor boy music. I wrote a song once called Poor Boy Boogie, and I have a thing about how people can make music without having to go through all this process of making a bunch of money and buying a guitar and all this stuff. There's a million ways that poor guys, when I grew up down south, everybody just made their own kind of music. And one of the ways, the most famous way, and I think everybody does down there, is sit around a circle. And you got a guy that does a thing called a ham bone. And the ham bone goes like this. Nothing to it. Now, if you get cool, you can pop your lips at the same time and go. And drop a tambourine while you're at it. Now, wait a minute. Now, there's more to it than that. Now, they've got a thing that they call eefin. In order to eef, most people, you breathe real fast. And I was talking about this before with somebody else, I think. But to eef, you go, and that goes along with the guy that goes, and all everybody's doing this at the same time. Now you're starting to get to feel good, see? Anyway, I'm gonna go on. There's a guy that, there's always some guy around that can play one of these. Now it don't take much to afford one of these. It's less than a buck. It's called a Jew's harp. I called it a juice harp, but I learned later on that it's called a Jew's harp. You do this, you go. You have to play this very carefully. It's like eating a tomato sandwich. It could fall right through the crust on you. And you play this wrong and knock your teeth right out of your head. Then there's some guys that can eef and play this at the same time. Now, I just happen to be about the only man and I know that can do that. Anyway, here's how you do. You get this guy going while everybody else is going eef. This guy's going. So much for the juice harp. Now this is a pair of spoons. Your best pair of spoons to learn how to play is your plain old Army Surplus soup spoons. They're great, they make a fantastic sound, but you tend to lose one of them. And playing one spoon is like taking a shower with a raincoat on. So you get these, they're stuck together with a piece of Lawrence Welk plastic on the bottom. And they stick together and make a pretty good sound. You play, you just spread the fingers out on one hand and go. All right, that's fun. Is that neato? Whatever. So much for poor boy music. I'll tell you what, everybody's feeling good now. Let's make some poor boy music together. Now, I want everybody in this audience to eat this thing. Now, we were talking about eefing a while ago, and a lot of people think that ain't easy to do. It is. You don't have to go ee and hyperventilate yourself or A lot of people do that and get excited. I don't want that to happen here. All you have to do, if you can't do it without hyperventilating or getting excited, all you have to do is say eef, if, eef, if, eef, if. Now do it in your lowest voice. This includes girls. And you jocks that can't handle it, lay out. Everybody else, I want you to go eef, if, eef, if, eef, if. Come on, let me hear you. If, eef, if. Big deep voice. Eef, if, eef. That's all, let me hear you do it now. Eef, if, eef, if, eef, if. Keep with me. Poor boy don't need electronics to make no rock and roll. Poor boy got boogie woogie born right in his soul.
Aye, eef, aye.
Poor boy got rhythm. Poor boy got blues. Poor boy got boogie woogie bubbling in his shoes. Let me hear you. Eef, aye, eef. Do you know how ridiculous you look? It's amazing what you can make people do. You've been sitting on the floor all night and you're all sitting out there going, eef, hey, eef. God love you, man. That's what makes it. That's poor boy music. Fun, right? Gorgeous. Beautiful. All right. Fantastic. Thank you. Thank you very much. You're clapping for yourselves because you're beautiful people. This is, I'd like, you know, you can talk about poor boy music and everything, but the next step from Ethan and Jews harping and slapping your knee in your chest and looking like an idiot is to buy yourself a cheap banjo or a cheap guitar or something. And I can think of no better way than to bring up the film clip from Deliverance, which was brought back by popular request, popular demand, whatever you call it. It's called Dueling Banjos, and I want everybody to watch it.
We're going to get into
a guy whose name is Waylon Jennings, and he started out as a country boy and a country artist, and he crossed the bridge, I think, before anybody else did. He got started with late Buddy Holly and the Crickets. He was a disc jockey once, Lubbock, Texas, where I grew up, and I'm going to tell you something. He has crossed the bridge, and he's going to make you feel good. He's a good man, and I want everybody to give him a big hand. The great Waylon Jennings.
Well, you can have, I don't want, she didn't love it anyway. She only wanted someone to play with. All I wanted was love to stay. The girl I loved up and left her. She ran away with my best friend. Comes home at night for just 1 hour. My best friend comes home at night for just 1 hour. When daylight comes, Lord, she's up and gone.
My next guest is one of my favorites.
Couldn't remember the name.
Yeah, Henry Hohannel. This is a very bright and very funny and a very creative lady, Joan Rivers.
So it's a great looking audience, which is getting me very depressed. Because, all the girls are legs, a belt, a brassiere, and long hair, which I don't need. These are the kind of girls that swim without bathing caps. Yeah! You know that kind? They come out of the pool and they go step, step, flick. And every hair falls into place. It kills me. I come out of the pool, I go flick, my wig goes flying. Dog in the pool! But California has the best women, don't you think?
I think they're fantastic. Really,
it's true. Yes,
they are good.
And the bodies are great, too, because I went to a nudist camp. And it's like, I went because I wanted to get a routine. But did you ever go to one of those?
No, I couldn't. I don't think I could hide emotions.
That's not what I was worried about. But you get very embarrassed because not only do they make you take off all your clothes, but they shave my dog. And that got me crazy.
They do that to everybody that goes into a nudist camp. I don't even know why I'm in this conversation.
No, but it's very healthy, because California's all health people out here. Don't you think? Much more than New York, they're all athletic out here. New York, nobody's athletic. The only athletic things you do in New York is like you run to your house and you lock your door.
It's good deep breathing exercises in New York. It's like Ethan. You can learn to Ethan in New York.
A what?
Eve. There's an it's a country thing. And
you must have been a terrific date.
Leave me alone.
No, I don't date anymore, thank God, because I'm married now. Ha ha. But not that, that doesn't even mean anything anymore. In my day,
really?
It meant there was much more pressure now than kids get. You don't get that much pressure yet, do you?
No.
Well, men, you'll never get pressure. Even in my day, if you were 90, you were a guy, you were a catch. It meant nothing. You have an extra man, bring him along, he's dead. Bring him, we'll prop him. You could take a dead guy, keep him till spring if you lived in a cold climate, But girls, I was 28 and single, and toward the end, my mother wrote my name in men's rooms. I mean, she just didn't care.
I called you once. You're the one.
Now I remember the breathing.
What a football.
No one called. It was very sad. I used to go on dates. That's what made me think about it. But even today, girls on dates are the charming ones, right? The girl's got to be the good sport. Doesn't that get you crazy? The man shows up, it's like, thank goodness, is the girl Miss Fun. Woo-hoo-hoo, you know. the Coke stand again, whippy-whippy. Guy steps through your skirt, you go, oh, it didn't count, it was new. It's a whole thing. Girl makes conversation. How'd you enjoy prison? You're always just, you know, chatting away.
Oh,
see?
Boy.
Which is why I'm glad we're sort of liberated now. See, it's a whole different world. I'm very glad what's happened has happened.
Oh, me too. Otherwise, I wouldn't have been elected Male Chauvinist Pig of the Month.
Yes. Were you in a fold out in the barnyard or just...
It was more like a fall down.
No, but the whole society now is much better. I still fit in. That's why I'm on the show. I have tie-dyed my girdle. I really am very Except I was invited to a pot party and I brought Tupperware. I have a right to be here. I played the piano as a kid.
Oh, I had no idea. Whatever really that. Didn't.
Thank you. There's one person going.
There's a lot of people here have tried
yeah,
piano.
Yeah, but my piano teacher was a dirty old man. You know, he was teaching piano, but he was thinking organs, so I figured.
Hey, everybody, let's have it for Joan Rivers. Wonderful lady. You know, every artist is influenced by someone, and I know you spent a lot of time with Ray Charles.
Yeah, I worked with Ray for about 3 years.
Well, I think everybody would like to spend just a few minutes with Ray Charles, and 3 years with him, you got to be a gas, man.
Yeah, definitely, man. It's a great honor.
Well, this is this guy can pick and grin along with Ray or the best of them, and I'm going to tell you, speaking of Ray, were you ever influenced by him at all? I mean, did he have any influence on your music?
Oh, yeah, a great deal. I used to imitate him all the time, you know, all of his songs and stuff.
Well, a lot of people have tried and a lot of people have failed. I understand you do a pretty good shot at him, though. Would you like to do it?
I'll try.
Hey, will you do it?
It's
all. Sock it to him. Dig this.
It's all.
Georgia. Oh, Georgia. A song of you now. Yes, it's a sweet song. Hey, and I now keeps Georgia on my mind.
The right Reverend. That's fantastic, man. I tell you, you got your own thing, though, man. And a lot of people that were lucky enough to see the concert for Bangladesh or maybe hear it on the radio know that Billy was a showstopper in the show. And I'd like to get him to do a song right now from that show called That's the Way God Planned It. Knock him out.
Okay. Thank you, man.
Why can't we be humble like the good Lord said? He promised to exalt us, but low is the way. How men be so greedy when there's so much left? All things are God-given and they all have been blessed. That's the way God planned it. That's the way God wants it. That's the way God planned it. That's the way God wants it to be. Yeah, yeah. Let not your heart be troubled. Let mourning, sobbing cease. Just learn how to help one another and live in perfect peace. If we all would be humble like the good Lord said, he said he would exalt us all, but no is the way. That sing the song. Help me sing the song. That's the way God planned it. That's the way God wants it to be. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Think about it. Somebody will. You may not understand me, but Billy will love you still. That's the way God planned me. That's the way God wants me to be. Yes, it is. Yes, it is now. That's the way God planned it. That's the way God wants it to be. Come on now. Come on now.
This is a song that I wrote a long time ago, and it's based on the premise that God respects you when you work, but he loves you when you sing. And I really believe in that. I think everybody ought to learn to sing together. You'd end up having a lot more fun. And also, you can squeak on your seat pads together. It makes a lot of nice noise if you can do it in rhythm. Anyway, I'm going to do my part of the song, and I want everybody to join in at a specified point of time, and I'm gonna let you know when. You'll see. I could just sit around making music all day long. Long as I'm making music, I know I can't do nobody wrong. And who knows, maybe someday I'll come up with a song that makes people won't stop their fussing and fighting just long enough to sing along. Help me out now. I believe in music. I believe in love. I believe in... I didn't say nothing about clapping. Clapping comes later on in the song. Right now, you're clapping to keep from having to sing. I've done this before, and I've seen it happen before. Everybody figures if I clap and move my mouth, he'll think I'm singing along with it. I know better than that. Just disregard clapping for a little while until the middle of this verse, and then I want everybody to sing along. Right now, I want everybody to sing along. Let me hear you. I believe in music. I can hear you. I believe in love. Beat that. I believe in music. God knows I believe in love. Not bad. Well, music is love. Love is music, if you know what I mean. And people who believe in music are the happiest people I've ever seen. So clap your hands, stomp your feet, shake your tambourine. Lift your voices to the sky. God loves you when you sing. Everybody now, I believe in music. I can hear you.
I believe in love. Come on, people, high. I believe in music. God knows I.
Everybody raise your right hand. Come on, raise them up in the air. This'll be fun. All right, all you teeny boppers, give the peace sign. Turn around and shake hands with the person behind you. it ain't easy. I'm sorry, I apologize. At least you're friends with each other, right? Sorry for the girl with the miniskirt back there. If I'd known you sitting behind Cool Hand Luke, I never would have pulled that on you. At least you're friends with each other, right? Let me hear you sing. I believe in music. I can't hear you. I believe in love. A little bit louder. I believe in music. God knows I believe in love. All right, you got it by yourself. Let me hear you. I believe in music. Come on, let me hear you. Harmony. Come on, louder.
I believe in music.
It'll make you feel good.
I believe in love.
Come on, let me hear you.
I believe in music.
I believe in you. God bless y'all. Thank you.
Try and concentrate. Open up your mind. It's rough and tough in the game, Lord. It's rough and tough. Make your father proud, make him proud. A lot of funny stuff going down in the ghetto. Am I telling the truth? Am I telling the truth? Right.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Mac Davis was kind enough to introduce me, and I'd like to return the favor because he's dynamite. He writes some dynamite things, dynamite material. And I'd like to introduce him because he has a brand new song to introduce. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Mac Davis.
It's 2 a.m. in Nashville, midnight in L.A. You're asleep and I'm out on the road. And I know that you can't hear me, but I'm talking anyway. Helps me kill some time and ease the load. Hon, the man didn't like my songs and he sent me on my way. And I blew my bus fare home in Tootsie's bar. Now I'm out on Murfreesboro Road hitchhiking to L.A. And the rain's pouring down on my guitar. Won't you dream? Dream me home. Dream me safely back to your door. I wish you a dream. Dream me home. And I swear that I won't leave you no to help out a long-haired hippie freak at 2 a.m. in Nashville, Tennessee. They threw me out of the truck stop and I got no place to sleep. If this is freedom, Lord, it ain't for me. Hon, I'm hanging up my Nashville dreams as soon as I get home. And I'll share my songs with no one else but you. We'll sing them up together, they'll be mine and yours alone. I'll be all the things you wanted me to. If you'll just dream, dream me home. Dream me safely back to your door. I wish you would dream. Dream me home, and I swear that I won't leave you no more. Baby, dream, dream me home. Come on, baby, dream, dream me home.
I hope I never have to do this song again.
And every night they lie awake and dream of Mama's chocolate cake and wonder if there'll be a tomorrow. And will they ever see their home and their family? Oh, will they ever be back home? Oh. And boys who never learn to pray look to the heavens every day and stumble through a simple little prayer. And ask the Lord above, please send me home to the ones I love. Oh God, I hope they make it home. Oh. And every day some young boy dies, and in the night some young girl cries. He'll never hear his baby's laughter. He'll never ever see his home or his family. But I guess he's fine. At least he's on his way back home.
Thank you.
Thank you. Well, so far I've had a ball tonight. I want to thank all the wonderful guests who helped make it possible. And you out there watching, don't forget, next week your host will be fantastic Harry Chapin. Good morning.
Half the world is world and half the world is sky. Half of everything is all that really meets the eye. Half of me is you, and half of you is me. Together we are one, and that's the way that it should be. La 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 la.
Listen to this.
Half a song is melody, and half a song is words. Half a song is not a half a song until it's heard. I can sing the words if you can hum the melody. Together we can sing a song, and that's how it should be. La la la.
It's your turn.
La 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 la.
Come on, partner.
La 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 la
world is night. Half the world is black as night and half the world is white. I have half a handshake, take it and you'll see. Together we'll be friends and that's the way that it should be. La la la, la la la, la la la, la la la. Your turn.